Pasta. is by Salomone Rossi, a violinist and composer during the beginning of the 17th century. He was a Jewish composer who created a path-breaking collection of Hebrew works, Hebrew motets for the synagogue. Rossi was active in the city of Mantua and within the Mantua court between 1587 and 1600. Hallelujah, Halleli Nafshi, or Psalm 146, is one of the songs of praise in the Book of Psalms. The trio in this song is sung by David Fang as tenor, Etienne Eason as alto, and Nika Gerwitz as soprano.
And we have the great privilege of having our beloved accompanist, Philip Crozier, with us tonight.
Thank you. Nunc Dimittis by Gustav Holst is one of the many choral works set to the sacred canticle, otherwise known as the Song of Simeon. Its Latin name comes from the opening line of the piece, which roughly translates to "Now let you depart." This specific rendition was first performed on Easter Sunday of the year 1915 at the Westminster Cathedral, and we are just as excited to perform it for you today. And finally, a big thank you to our wonderful soloists, soprano Dahlia Waller and tenor Daniel Hamby.
Chamber Choir's last work, we'll be performing a piece that is a little different from the rest of our repertoire that we've been singing this evening. It's going to be Jakub Nesko's Bironcharnia. This contemporary choral work was awarded by Maestro Ennio Morricone in the first international competition of choral composition in 2014. We hope you enjoy it.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. It's going to be a brief 10-minute intermission. Enjoy yourselves, but we're going to be right back in 10 minutes. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. Hi. So our program opens with this stately, majestic fanfare, a wonderful, inspiring message featuring a text adapted from Psalms. It moves into jubilant high gear featuring a rhythmically driving accompaniment, and the lyrical flowing middle section provides a unique contrast for this alluring work. Now, let me use my voice and say that I have a secret. Well, we all have a secret. But who do you trust with the secret? The secret is a piece that extols the mysteries of nature and life. The secret is an excerpt from the lyrics of Lowly Life by Paul Laurence Dunbar, 1872 to 1906. He was a pivotal writer during the Harlem Renaissance. He wrote with so much emotion and expression. So this piece features word painting, rich harmonies, haunting melodies, and contrasting major, minor keys with a flowing piano accompaniment. And a secret you can't keep, because you'll be talking about the piece forever, I assure you. Or are you?
Thank you. light. Light in the midst of darkness, as the earth turns from darkness towards longer, brighter days, is central to many cultures. We think of the winter solstice, of Kwanzaa's festival of lights, the glowing stars and lights of Christmas. During Eid of Ramadan, light guides the way. Diwali celebrates the spiritual victory of light over darkness. May the light and peace of Hanerot, of the candles in our next song, return to the peoples of the Middle East and the world. Hanerot.
So one day in the late 90s, I was a kid on the weekend flipping through the musical theater CDs in the library because that's how popular I was. And I was just about to leave with my usual armful of Andrew Lloyd Webber when I saw this CD case with the words Rent in bold in this graphic imagery, and I thought, maybe I'll try something new. So, Rent is about a group of friends in New York, artists, grappling with issues like poverty, addiction, heartbreak, disease, and loss, and all the drugs and sex and rock and roll. This was not your grandpappy's musical. They were all different in background, culture, sexuality, religion, but that didn't matter to them. What mattered was the love and the power of friendship that kept them together. Rent was a musical based on Puccini's opera, La Bohème. Jonathan Larson said that he wanted to revolutionize the modern musical, and he did. But sadly, he passed away just a few days short of the musical ever seeing the stage. So when this piece, Seasons of Love, was first performed, the cast decided to honor him by opening the musical with this number. So I hope you enjoy and remind you that we should all be measuring our lives in love.
So they say this next song, Diraton, is based on a poem by Rainer Maria Rilke. Rilke was a German-speaking poet born in Prague in the late 19th century. In the 1920s, he wrote a series of poems in French called Les Roses. More than half a century later, a contemporary American composer, Morten Lauritsen, used five of Rilke's poems for a choral cycle he called Les Chansons des Roses. Diraton is one of those songs. They say that Lauritsen had the inspiration to write music while he served as a forest fire ranger on an isolated lookout tower somewhere near Mount St. Helens, a great place to contemplate your future. I won't attempt to explain what this song is about, except to say that it is very contemplative, very introspective, verging on the narcissistic. But never mind all that. Just sit back, contemplate in your mind's eye a perfect rose, and listen to the wondrous harmonies of Diraton.
next piece is actually called Pineywood Mountain. And you know, stopping and clapping sections to me sounds like chopping down wood, like trees, since Pineywood, as the name would suggest, is a forest region filled with pine trees. So come and take a journey with us to Pineywood Mountain.
Antonio Vivaldi was ordained as a priest in 1703, though he instead chose to follow his passion for music as a director of music at an orphanage for girls, Ospedale della Pietà. He was a prolific Baroque composer who left a substantial amount of sacred music and hundreds of his work behind, one of which is Magnificat. The earliest known version of Magnificat in G minor, composed for the orphanage in around 1715, was revised in the 1720s as RV610A, making the tenor and bass parts more suitable for male voices. This is the version we're singing for you today. Vivaldi structured Magnificat in 9 movements, 8 for the canonical text, and a conclusion for the doxology. I personally love this piece. I find it quite comprehensive. It has moments that are grim and heavy, as well as moments that are soft and lively. So just sit and relax and let these combinations surprise you. As I said, note that this piece is long and it has 9 movements, so please do not clap in between movements and wait until the end of the piece. I also have to mention that the alto solo is replaced by Emily Chaudat. I hope you enjoyed this piece as much as I do.
Thank you. Hi, so this last piece we're performing is by the same composer as The Secret. His name is Greg Gilpin, and this is a gospel setting. Feel free to join along. The words are very simple. You should hear them, and hopefully we all leave here feeling a little full of music. So thank you.